Hi everybody, today is February 20th, 2013. Judge support Ken Burns in Central Park 5 lawsuit. A New York judge has rejected the city's attempt to subpoena outtakes from Ken Burns' 2012 documentary, The Central Park 5. The movie follows the case of five men who were convicted for a 1989 rape of a Central Park jogger and exonerated for the crime in 2002 thanks to DNA evidence. The wrongfully accused brought a federal lawsuit against the city soon after they were vindicated. Evidently, a man who was in prison admitted to the crime, and the DNA evidence confirmed that he was the guilty party. Last year, the city's lawyer subpoenaed unreleased footage and other materials from Burns' documentary to bolster their defense, arguing that the film had crossed from documentary to pure advocacy. Burns and his co-directors refused to comply, saying that the city's request was neither appropriate nor enforceable. Under the governing law for subpoenas served on professional journalists exercising their right of independent free speech, Magistrate Judge Ronald L. Ellis of the United States District Court in Manhattan agreed with Burns in court yesterday, ruling that Burns is still entitled to journalistic privilege under the law, even though his film was sympathetic to the Central Park Five. Indeed, it seems likely that a filmmaker would have a point of view going into a project, the judge wrote. Burns, who is currently vacationing with his family, released a statement about the decision, saying that he and his collaborators think Judge Ellis made exactly the right ruling. We are also mindful that this ruling goes far beyond our current situation. This adds a layer of important protection to journalists and filmmakers everywhere, he continued. We recognize, too, that this attempt to subpoena our outtakes and notes only further delayed the nearly decade-long efforts by the plaintiff to seek redress. We hope this serves as a positive impetus to move that original suit to a resolution. Evidently, at the end of his documentary, he said that New York City should come to terms and make good, I guess, for what was done to these people. And because he made his own personal statement at the end, they said he was no longer classified as a journalist. And being a journalist, you have certain protections. So they felt that he no longer was protected and had to give up his notes and outtakes because of his freedom of speech. New York's just getting way out of control lately. Telling you what you can and can't eat. Bringing in portable x-ray machines to start x-raying people on the streets. Warrantless searches. Body searches on the streets. Alright, bookmark my site. I keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.